This is an important question of the surface tension. Today I discuss about the surface tension. So now I am discussing about the important question answer of the surface tension and total introduction of the surface tension elaborately. Okay, so everyone please follow this video. So easily you can understand what is surface tension, what do you mean surface tension, what is the function or role of the surfactant in the surface tension, their application, surface tension, determination of surface tension, which type of equipments or which type of capillary is used for the surface tension, how can you determine the surface tension unknown for unknown sample, everything. So first of all, I am starting with different type of questions. So this type of questions is very important, everyone please follow. This type of question is perhaps only surface tension. What do you mean surface tension? What is the surface tension of water? What is the formula of surface tension? Why surface tension is very much important, and what liquids have the strongest surface tension, what factors affect surface tension, what type of force is surface tension, how do you decrease the surface tension, does pressure affect surface tension, and what is the examples of surface tension, and what happens if surface tension decreases, and what affects the surface tension also, which has highest surface tension at room temperature, why does the surface tension decrease with temperature also, why is the interfacial tension less than surface tension. Actually interfacial tension or interfacial force, it is very important into the surface tension, and generally surface tension is produced into the liquid. When the interfacial force is, interfacial force means cohesive force between the liquid particles. This type of force is applied, then the every particle, then the agitation or attractive power will be created into the every particles, large particles. And then this type of particles are attracted with each other, okay, and then the all liquid particles are close together, and that time the surface of the liquid, on the surface of the liquid a pressure will be created, okay, and the thin layer will be created, that is called a surface tension, and surfactant is used to reduce the surface tension. Example, detergent, soap, etc., everything I will discuss elaborately in this video. So this is the important question, just like a suggestion you can say also. And does oil reduce surface tension? This is very important, very confusing question. What if water has no surface tension, then what will be happened, and does air have surface tension, and how does the detergent break surface tension? Everyone knows that this detergent is a one type of surfactant, and surfactant is reduce the surface tension. Now question is the how does detergent break surface tension? Does sugar increase the surface tension? Anybody can hear that the sugar is increases surface tension, yes or no? All what temperature surface tension of water is minimum? This is very important question. Another question is why do electrolytes, just like a salt, sodium chloride, it is increases the surface tension? How do you measure the surface tension by stalagmometer? Very important. Which equipments are used to determine? Stalagmometer. What is the critical surface tension? Everyone knows that the surface tension, but what do you mean critical surface tension? What is the advantages of high surface tension of the water, and why does the water have high surface tension and but low viscosity? This is very confusing. The water has a high surface tension but viscosity is very low. Why? So how do you measure the surface tension by stalagmometer? This is very important part. So this is the point, determination of the surface tension of unknown liquid by drop count and drop weight method. So this is very important part. So I will discuss today, and everyone please follow this video so easily you can understand. And I think after this video you have a small idea about the surface tension. Uh, determination of surface tension of unknown liquid by drop count method. This determination of surface tension is very important. Okay, I have told about already what do you mean surface tension, surface tension application, their use, what is the surface tension of water and what is the mechanism of surface tension and what is the function of surfactant, example of surfactant, and what is the role of surfactant in surface tension. They are very important. Okay, so I think if you have a small idea about the surface tension. So now the determination of surface tension. Surface tension determination is one type of practical process. It is very interesting process. So already I have told the stalagmometer equipment is used to determine the surface tension. So please everyone follow this diagram, then you can understand easily. This is the diagram of the stalagmometer. Okay, this is the diagram of the stalagmometer. So here A and B, two part. Okay, this is the A part and this is B part. Okay, and this is not A part, this is A part. Okay, so how you determine the surface tension of unknown liquid? First of all, any type of unknown liquid you have to compare with the water sample. And water, everyone knows that the surface tension of the water is 72 dyne per centimeter square. Okay, but when you will determine any type of unknown liquid, then first of all you have to check the water surface tension and then the unknown liquid surface tension compared with the water surface tension, that means the known sample. Water is a known sample. So this is the diagram of the stalagmometer and capillary is here already. The capillary tube is attached with the stalagmometer and this is the liquid part. Okay, and unknown sample in here, if you will take the liquid paraffin, so first of all liquid paraffin you have to place here. Okay, point A, from point B to point A, here the you have to place the liquid paraffin. Okay, and so what is the process? In this case the stalagmometer balance and beaker are used to determine the surface tension, because surface tension determination it is determined by two method, drop count method and drop weight method. Now I discuss about the drop count method and after that I will discuss about the drop weight method. So first of all, how will you drop count method you will prepare, you will perform. So in this case the stalagmometer balance beaker are used to determine the surface tension of unknown sample with known sample also. So this is the beaker and this is the stalagmometer and capillary tube also here placed, and this is part is the liquid paraffin. Okay, unknown sample. And if you will take first of all the water here, so you can perform easily. So first of all you can take here water, and so at first water is taken as a standard at room temperature, and the drops of water through the stalagmometer, then point A to B. Okay, this is the fall of water drops. Okay, and counted the drops also. Okay, and the number of drops of water put into the formula also. And what is the formula? I will discuss. Wait. And after that, the same process, liquid paraffin will take in the stalagmometer, and you can calculate the drops, one drops of liquid paraffin from A point to from B point into the beaker, and after that you can easily collect from the beaker. So what is the formula? Formula means the surface tension, this is the observation table here also present. So everyone please can understand by this table. the number of drops of water here, 3 times you can perform the 3 times, 4 times, 5 times, etc. Whatever you want. So here 3 times I will discuss number of drops for water. This is like example. And here the number of drops for liquid paraffin, okay? And what is the formula? Formula, when you will determine the unknown sample, that means liquid paraffin, the surface tension of the liquid paraffin, then the what is the formula? Formula will be the number surface tension equals to number of drops of water divided by number of drops of unknown liquid into density of the unknown liquid divided by density of water into surface tension of the water. So density of water at 20 degree centigrade, it equals to 0.9977 gram per centimeter cube. This is standard. And surface tension of the water, it is also standard, 7 to 2 dyne per centimeter. And density of the liquid paraffin, it is also standard, 0.820 to 0.880 gram per centimeter cube. This is may be varied. So by this formula you can easily you will get the surface tension of the unknown sample. Okay, so what is the drop count method? When you will perform by drop count method to determine the surface tension of the liquid paraffin or any type of unknown sample, so first of all you have to take a stalagmometer and a beaker. Okay, and the capillary is already attached with the stalagmometer, and unknown sample you have to take here. Okay, and this, in this stalagmometer, the A point and B point you have to mark first of all, and it is put into the beaker stalagmometer, and after that you have to count one drop of unknown sample from A to B point. Okay, this is the one drop. Okay, and then you can easily count the drop number of drops of unknown sample. And formula, this is the formula, surface tension of the number drops of the water divided by number drops of unknown liquid into density of the unknown liquid by density of the water into surface tension of the water. So density of the water and surface tension of the water and density of the liquid paraffin, these are standard. Okay, so by this formula you can easily understand or easily determine the surface tension of the liquid paraffin or any type of unknown sample. So if you want the to determine the water, the surface tension of the water, then that time this process will be same. Otherwise you know the surface tension of the water, 72 dyne per centimeter. But if you want the clarify or to check this type, this surface tension of the water is right or wrong, so you will take the water in the stalagmometer and same process. Okay, stalagmometer, and then you have to count the drop of water one by one, and after that this formula you have to put into the and after that when you will collect the drop of water from the beaker, then by this formula you can easily determine the surface tension of the water. Okay, so this is the drop count method. Okay, if you want to check the surface tension of the water, then this process you can easily apply. So this process, this drop count method process, you can apply for standard surface tension of the water also, or any type of unknown sample of the liquid also. So mainly you have to determine the, actually you know that according to IP Indian Pharmacopoeia, actually you know that the what is the surface tension of the water, because this is standard. But you have to determine the any type of unknown sample. So this formula is very important, drop count method. Another method is the drop weight method. This method I will discuss. Another method is a drop weight method. So how will you drop weight method you will perform? What is the drop weight method? Same process, actually stalagmometer and beaker you have to use, and surface tension of the water, you know that this is standard, but you have to determine the drop weight method by the drop weight method of unknown sample also. So procedure will be the drops or unknown liquids are collected in a clean beaker. After the drop count method, you will collect the drop of the drop with beaker, and which is previously cleared and weight of the drops of liquid is determined. And repeat the procedures with water at room temperature and surface tension of given liquid is calculated. But here the single beaker you have to previously on the starting of practical you have to weigh the single beaker without any type of drop, okay? Because in this formula, that means by drop weight method formula, the single beaker weight is very important. So this is a one type of part also. So observation table is here. Number of drops of liquid paraffin you have to record it, weight of the beaker with sample and weight of the beaker with water drops and number of drops of water. Okay, you have to first of all record, you have to collect this record, and then the formula of the drop weight method is first of all weight of the one drop of given sample. One drop of given sample is denotes by W1. So W1 equals to weight of beaker with sample minus weight of beaker. That's why I have told on the starting practical you have to weigh the single beaker, weight of beaker, and then total divided by the numbers of drops of liquid paraffin, that means unknown sample, okay? And W2, it is denoted by the weight of the drops of water. So this is the same formula. And after that, the surface tension of the given liquid, that means unknown sample, Y1 equals to W1 by W2 into Y2. W1 and W2 already I got. So into Y2, that means surface tension of the water, 72 per centimeter square. So easily from this calculation, you can get the Y1, that means the surface tension of the liquid paraffin or unknown given sample, you can get easily. Okay, so this is the total formula of the drop count and drop weight method. So when you will determine or when you will perform the surface tension of the unknown sample, then drop weight method and drop count method both are very important, and you have to perform both method, because without drop weight method this is not authenticate, and without drop count method this is also not authenticate. So first of all you have to perform the drop count method. So what is the main practical of the drop count and drop weight method? So first of all, on the starting of the practical you have to weigh a single beaker. Okay, then stalagmometer and beaker you have to collect it, and you will know, you know already the water, the surface tension of the water is 72 per centimeter square, and you have to determine the any type of unknown given sample. So first of all you have to place the unknown sample into the stalagmometer, and it is dipped into the beaker also, and from A point to from B point you have to count the drop, one drop of unknown sample. Okay, then you can get easily drop count method also. And what is the formula of the drop count method? I have already told, number of drops of water divided by number of drops of unknown liquid into the density of unknown liquid by density of water into surface tension of the water. Okay, here density of the water and surface tension water and density of the liquid paraffin are standard. Another part is the drop weight method. Drop weight method means after counting the drop count method, this total liquid sample with beaker you have to weight it, and then this formula you have to apply it. From this formula you can easily understand what is the surface tension of the unknown liquid sample, So drop weight and drop count method both are very important. Okay. So which question I have told already, these are very much important for surface tension. Now I'm discussing their answer also. Okay, so please everyone follow this answer. Already I have told what is the important questions from surface tension chapter, but now I'm discussing their answer also. So first of all, what do you mean surface tension? Already I have told what do you mean surface tension. I think you have idea about the concept of surface tension, but this is the theoretical definition of the surface tension. And the molecules of the interior of a liquid attract one another equally in all directions, and at the surface of the liquid the attraction is only in downward, and it is only in downward and the sideward direction, and this causes the surface layer to exist in a state of tension which is called surface tension. Due to this tension the surface of a liquid acts like a stretch elastic membrane also, which exert pressure inward on the rest of the liquid. This force causes liquid to assume the form of a spherical drop, and in this form it has the smallest surface area for a given volume, and surface tension is expressed in dyne per centimeter square. That means this is the unit of the surface tension. Okay, and what is the meaning of the interfacial tension? The tension at liquid or gas surfaces is called surface tension, and that at liquid or liquid surface is called the interfacial tension. Actually interfacial tension means cohesive force between the particles. When this force is produced into the particles, then they are attracted with each other and they close together, and that time they are all close together, that time the surface of liquid is very small, and surface of the liquid is liquid should be reduced, and that's why the surface of the liquid, a thin layer, a thin film is created on the surface of the layer, that is called a surface tension. And due to this cohesive force and due to the attractiveness between the particles, that's why the one type of pressure or one type of tensions are created on the surface of the liquid. So that's why when the all liquid particles are together and all liquid particles comes on the surface of the liquid, then a thin layer of the film is produced on the surface of liquid. That is called a surface tension, and that is called a interfacial force or interfacial tension also. Another point is measurement of surface tension. Already I have told how you determine the surface tension of liquid sample, that means known sample or unknown sample. So stalagmometer is a one type of equipment which is easily used for the determination of the surface tension of any type of liquid. Here in another type of methods are also important: capillary tube method, drop weight, drop count method, tensiometer method, stalagmometer method. When you use stalagmometer method, then drop count and drop count method, both methods are very important. And surface tension is the tendency of liquid surfaces to shrink into the minimum surface area possible, and surface tension allows the insects visually denser than the water to float and slide on a water surface. A tension of the surface film of a liquid causes by the attraction of the particles in the surface layer by the bulk of the liquid, okay, and which tends to minimize the surface area. Actually surface tension, it has a tendency to minimize the surface area. Another question is, what is the surface tension of the water? This is standard and everyone knows that. Now, what is the surface tension of the water? Surface tension of the water is a 72.8 dyne per centimeter at 20 degree centigrade.
and ethyl alcohol, it has a surface tension is, it is also compared to the water 22.3 for ethyl alcohol and 465 for mercury. So another question is, what is the formula of the surface tension? What is the formula? Already I have told on the determination of the surface tension, that time already I have discussed the formula of the surface tension, but now this formula is clear, everyone can understand that gamma equals to force by length. Gamma means surface tension, F means force and D means length. Okay, and why is surface tension is very important? What is the importance of surface tension? It is determines the efficiency of detergent formulation. The high surface tension of water makes it a relatively more clearly detergent, and by increasing the temperature of water and the cleaning efficiency increases slightly as surface tension decreases. Okay, so these questions are very important. And another question is, what is the surface tension depends on? Surface tension depends actually mainly upon the forces of attraction, you know, between the particles and with the given liquid, and also upon gas, solid and liquid in contact with it, and the molecules in a drop of water, for example, attracted with each other. That means the cohesive force, that means interfacial force and particles also. And what liquids have the strongest surface tension? Water. What factors affect surface tension? Which type of factors are very important for the surface tension? Temperature, soluble impurities, insoluble impurities, etc. Temperature, when the surface tension of the liquid decreases with the increases of it. That means when the temperature is increased, then the surface tension will be decreased. Soluble impurities, the presence of soluble impurities may be increased or decrease the surface tension. Okay. And insoluble impurities decreases, only decreases the surface tension. Next question, what type of force is surface tension? Already I have discussed the cohesive force or interfacial force. And next, what do you decrease? How do you decrease the surface tension? Surfactants. Surfactants is very important, and it plays an important role in the surface tension. Surfactant is used to reduce the surface tension, example detergent, soap, etc. And it is also playing as a wetting agent, emulsifier, foaming agents, dispersant, etc. Does pressure affect surface tension? As temperature and pressure increases, the surface tension of the polystyrene decreases. A linear relationship is found between the surface tension and temperature, and between the surface tension and the temperature and pressure. So the slope of surface tension change with the temperature is dependent on pressure. What is the example of surface tension? Example, insects walking on the water, floating a needle on the surface of the water. This is the example. And what happens if surface tension decreases? Surface tension decreases when the temperature increases, because cohesive force decreases with an increased molecular thermal activity. So the influence of the surrounding environment is due to the adhesive action liquid molecules have at the interface. So this is the important question. Another question is, what affects surface tension? That means the surface tension is caused by the effects of the intermolecular forces at the interface. Surface tension depends on the nature of the liquid and surrounding environment and temperature also. And what increases water surface tension? At temperature decreases, then surface tension increases. And as surface tension decreases strong, as molecules become more active with an increase the temperature, becoming zero at it is boiling point and vanishing of the critical temperature. And what has more surface tension, oil and water? Water, obviously. And which has the highest surface tension at room temperature? Water. And why does the surface tension decrease with temperature? Why? surface tension decreases when the temperature increases because cohesive force decreases with an increase the molecular thermal activity. The influence of the surrounding environment is due to the adhesive action liquid molecules have at the interface. Another question is the surface tension. Does surface tension depend on surface area? Surface tension is much less dependent on the surface area, which the DPD molecule, even if the water in DPD model is much more sensitive to size effects. And why is interfacial tension less than surface tension? Why interfacial tension less than surface tension? The surface tension is reduced as some of the water molecules are replaced by the surfactant molecules, and interaction forces between the surfactant and water is less than between two water molecules. Okay, so surfactants are routinely used in industry to lower the surface and interfacial tension. Why do surfactant reduce surface tension? The reason for the reduction in the surface tension when surfactant molecules absorb at the water surface is that the surfactant molecules replace some of the water molecules in the surface. Another point, does salt increase the surface tension? Yes, adding salt to water does increases the surface tension of water. And does air have surface tension? No. Surface tension is due to attractive forces between the molecules, and they are only close enough together in a liquid only liquid purpose. So air has not surface tension. And another question is, what if water has no surface tension? In this condition, fluid will evaporate immediately, or it will act like gas. Does oil reduce surface tension? In a cup of water, and the surface tension is due to imbalance of the molecular forces, putting oil which has lower surface tension than water reduce the surface tension. What is the difference between surface tension and surface energy? Surface tension is the need for intermolecular force on the surface molecules of a liquid, but surface tension is defined as a force and parallel to the surface, perpendicular to a unique length line drawn on the surface. How does detergent break surface tension? Detergent, it is used as a surfactant. So how does detergent break surface tension? The end of the detergent molecules which attracts to fat, that means grease type, repels water molecules, and this weakens the hydrogen bonds holding the water molecules together at the surface. The sugar increases surface tension. Sugar such as dextrose, sucrose increases surface tension. That means the surface tension decreases continuously with the increasing concentration. Another question is, at what temperature surface tension of water is minimum? 70 degrees Celsius. Why do electrolytes increase surface tension? Why? Addition of solute into solvent may lead to an increase the surface tension, just as a salt. This is very important example in water, and water in alcohol due to solute depletion at the interface. And why does water have high surface tension but low viscosity? Why? This is very confusing question and very interesting. Water has a high surface tension but low viscosity. Why? Water's high surface tension is due to the hydrogen bonding in water molecules. Water has very strong intermolecular force, low vapor pressure, but it is even lower compared to longer molecules with the lower vapor pressure. And viscosity is the property of fluid having high resistance to flow. So that's why water has a low viscosity. And what is the advantages of high surface tension of water? It allows a clear boundary layer, much like non-Newtonian fluid, but it allows water to go with the capillary action, that is rising into the paint brush. Okay, so next question is, what is the critical surface tension? When I discuss discussed the quotient. That time the critical surface tension, I have already told about this. Everyone knows that surface tension, but what is critical surface tension? According to the Chessman method, the critical surface tension, the surface tension at which a liquid just completely wet a solid. The surface tension of different liquids is plotted against the cosine of the contact angle theta in order to determine the critical surface tension, and this method is called Chessman method. Okay. Why does salt water have the surface tension? The salt water has a much lower cohesion force, that means cohesive force, than plain water, so its attractive forces are less than the plain water. This is the difference between salt water and plain water. So I am discussing total answers about the questions which I have given this, but every answer now I am discussing, and you can download easily this type of answer as a note from my description part of the video. So everyone, please follow this video, and please you can download the notes from the description part of the video, okay, because I will give a link, and from link you can easily download from this notes. Okay, thank you.